may our whole lives prove that God is good. May our struggles keep us near the cross. May our troubles show that we
doing at the moment. Lord, we worship and adore you, Lord. We exalt and give you the glory. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. Glory to your name, Father. Holy Spirit, as we gather before your presence today, we ask, oh God, that you will speak to us. We ask, oh God, that you will touch our lives. We ask, oh God, that there will be great testimonies from today's ministration. In the name of Jesus, may the Spirit of God over everywhere. People are watching this broadcast. In the name of Jesus, may the Spirit of truth take charge of our world. And let Jesus alone be glorified. In Jesus' most wonderful name, we have prayed. I want to welcome us again to the presence of God, to the live worship on this day in the history of the world. I want to thank God for His grace that has kept us thus far. I want to bless His holy name. It is my prayer that every one of us that is listening to this broadcast or that is watching me would be touched and would be blessed tremendously. Let us open a Bible together to 2 Chronicles chapter 7 as we take the reading from verse 13 to 14. The word of God says, "If I shut up heaven that there be no rain, or if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, and I will forgive their sin, I will heal their land." Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. People of God, there is no situation in our contemporary time that is not covered or is not provided for in the Bible. We respond when there are national emergencies. What do we do when our nations are in turmoil, just as we see today? God is not unaware about what is going on and is concerned. If someone will ask me, is God actually concerned? I want to tell you, people of God, He is concerned. Thousands of people are dying, and the one who made them is concerned. He is concerned with what is going on in our world today. In our first broadcast after the lockdown, I told you that all these happenings are invitation by the Lord Himself. The Lord God is coming back to take over His world, the world He created for Himself. And people of God, He is reminding us that He still reigns over the affairs of men. He is calling our attention to take our eyes off those things that we have set our eyes up to and set our affection only to Him. The scriptures above is one of the biblical provisions for guidance in times like this. It provides for what God's people can do in times of national disaster. In times of global disaster, men and brethren, it is true, it is time for us to return to the Bible and the God of the Bible. There is the need for national and global repentance. See, brethren, if a nation will sincerely seek the Lord, if a nation will sincerely turn from their wicked way, the Lord will spare that nation. If an individual, if a family will sincerely seek the Lord, if an individual will maintain the position of the Lord will spare such an individual at a time like this. You want to ask me, how did I know God saved Noah and his family at a particular time where there was a global emergency? You want to ask me how I got to know God fed Elijah when there was famine? People of God, it kept him somewhere and a board was bringing daily provisions unto him. You know, a friend of mine from abroad spoke with me while I were coming for this recording, and I told him that now it is a time to actually pray the scriptures, give us this day our daily bread. When we have today's bread, we cannot think of what happens tomorrow. But God did that in the Bible. He fed Elijah, and Elijah survived a terrible time in their national history. If sincerely, people of God, will we hear this call? Will we hear this invitation? If you and I will take out time to seek the Lord, I tell you, people of God, the Lord will spare us. Hallelujah. He's a God that spares his people. He's a God that provides for his people. He's a God that no emergency can catch unawares. Hallelujah. Let's go. The build up to 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 13 to 14. Solomon had just completed a magnificent temple, and he prayed a very long prayer. People of God, the prayer spanned 31 verses. And you know, people of God, he was bringing up one issue or the other, speaking to God in the place of prayer, having built a magnificent temple unto the Lord. The prayer spanned from 2 Chronicles chapter 6, from verse 12 to verse 42. In his prayer, he mentioned many things to God. He was asking God to answer prayers from the temple, prayer made to God, looking at the direction of the temple. If people are in trouble, you know, mere locating the direction of the temple and pray that God should hear. Right? You know, people of God, it's so funny today. You know, the setting might not be the same. We might not be building a temple, but the Lord has given us a name that is above every other name, the name of Jesus. You know, in the time of Solomon, they had to locate the temple. And you discover that when Daniel was in a very big trouble in the land of Babylon, people of God, he had to locate the direction of the temple. That's why some religion today, they have to locate a particular direction before they can pray. You know, today we have been given a name. Hallelujah. The name Jesus. It does not matter the direction you are locating. It does not matter where you are. It does not matter the situation you find yourself. People of God, our God answers prayer from anywhere. If you could hear Jonah in the belly of the fish. Jonah, you know, depicted that situation as the belly of hell, that he was in hell. Cried to the Lord. The Lord heard him. The Lord can hear you. Hallelujah. And he will surely hear you in the name of Jesus. We need no temple, physical temple. I told you on Easter Day, Easter Sunday broadcast, that when Jesus died, the Holy of Holy was made bare. And the Jehovah God left the temple into our hearts. When man was in a perfect state, there was no need for a temple. Human being, we were meant to be the temple, carrying God. And today, because of Jesus, that Christ, the Lord God, had entered into our heart, now we carry him about because we are his temple. So you don't need to locate any Solomon temple, but the principle of the Solomon prayer is still applicable today. Hallelujah. In verse 28 of 2 Chronicles chapter 6, of the prayer of Solomon, you know, he made mention of some notable things, notable points, and I'll quickly read through that scripture. It says, when the heaven is shut up and there is no rain because they have sinned against them, yet if they pray towards this place and confess thy name and turn from their sin, when thou dost afflict them, if there be deaths in the land, just like we have in our land, if there be pestilence, if there be blasting or mildew, locusts or caterpillars, if their enemies besiege them in the cities of their land, or whatsoever sore or whatsoever sicknesses there be. He was asking God for those things, that the Lord, you know, should hearken unto his people when they seek him. You know, Solomon mentioned many things that could make the people to seek the Lord, and pleaded that whenever they call upon God, he should please answer them. After, you know, this prayer in chapter 7 from verse 1, God answered with naked fire and consumed the sacrifice that Solomon placed on the altar. And such is the power of prayer. God still answers, people of God. And you know, in verse 12 of chapter 7, from verse 12 downward, God began to give Solomon an answer to the prayers that Solomon prayed. You know, God is setting, like I told you, is different today. The principles are still applicable in our global pandemic situation that we find ourselves. So, people of God, what is the cause of national or global sickness? What can be the cause of national or global sickness? Solomon identified sin as the cause of national sickness. And you know, God agreed with him. If you look at that verse 26 of 2 Corinthians chapter 6, you know, he told God, when the Lord God shall be heavens, because the people have sinned against God. So what can cause, what can bring about national disaster, national emergency, national sickness, global sickness? He's saying, you know, people of God, our world is besieged with all manners of sins and sinful acts today. The church of God is not spared, people of God. There is no difference between the holy and the unholy anymore. There is nothing more that the people of Sodom did that our world has not done. No, our world has done many terrible things, people of God. Fathers sleeping with their daughters. You know, the only thing that is saving our world are the saints. The only thing that is saving our world is because you and I are still in this world. The world has done many terrible things. The world has done many terrible, terrific things. You know, a lot of things are happening in our world. This world is used up. This world is exhausted. This world is war-torn. This world is old, people of God. And there is, you know, we can't feel at home again any longer. Because, people of God, very soon, something is going to happen. Hallelujah. There is not what of them have done that this our world has not done. Sin is our major problem. Sin is the bane of the issues of our present world. What are the sins we are talking about? The sin of forgetfulness. Hey, we forget God. This is a sin, the greatest sin that the world has. It is easy to forget what makes us strong. It is easy to forget the secret of our strength. When a man assumes a particular level, because there is excessive knowledge now, because knowledge has increased, the love of people have waxed cold. People have forgotten about God. Our world has neglected God. Our God word has put God on the background, and God cannot be pushed to the background. Sin of forgetfulness. You see people acting as though God does not exist anywhere. You see our leaders acting as though God is nowhere. People of God, you know, particularly in America, at the turn of the century, you know, the last century, you know, all their foundations were based on biblical principles. Their leaders were sworn in with the Bible. But at the point to preach the gospel, to carry the gospel, to cite the scriptures in their schools became forbidden. It became forbidden to pray publicly in a public function using the name of God. And yet somebody can speak blasphemy against God and it will be all over the place and people will smile about it. Hey, people of God, that is the terrible state that our world has found itself in. You know, people of God, it is a time that people take up people, leaders of God, people, servants of God, and bring them into the public and begin to say all manners of nonsensical things about them. People have forgotten about God. We think politics can do it. We think democracy can do it. We tell people to use their PVC, the permanent voters card. Where is the PVC today? All the elections that were slated for April. Where are the people here today? God cannot be pushed to the background. Hallelujah. Sin of forgetfulness. That is the number one thing. You see, the foundation of all sin is sin of forgetfulness. When you forget about God, you begin to do so many other things. You enter into other sins when you forget about God. Another sin that has plagued, besieged our world is the sin of neglect. Neglect to worship God. Neglect to call upon Him. Neglect to serve Him. We serve other gods. We have enthroned other gods on our hearts. Neglect of God. Neglect of God. People of God, you will be shocked that even in the lockdown, people are still not seeking God. Go to the social media. You see nonsensical things that people are posting online to show to you that people have not even come to repentance. Neglect. We neglect God. We neglect to worship God. We worship all manners of things. We worship soccer. We worship money. We worship all manners of things, people of God. You know, sin of neglect. We neglect God in important decisions of our life. We neglect God in our businesses. We neglect God in our academics. You can imagine pastor's children who want to write WAEC and the parents would pay for machinery for such a child. Pastors will stand on the altar and preach against fornication. But the moment he's stepping out of the altar, he's going to fornicate. Neglect of God. We have neglected God in all aspects of our life. It is not the same rule that applies when we get, that applies in our workplaces. This is the time to seek the Lord. God is calling you and I to seek him at such a time as this. And we must seek the Lord. Sin of neglect of God. We have neglected to worship him. We fail to give glory to him. We neglect to call upon him. We can call our leader upon our leaders. We can call upon our parents. But we don't have time to call upon God. Neglect to serve him. We can serve any other thing, but not God. The third sin identified is the sin of rejection. Hey, this is a step beyond neglect. A person can neglect a thing or a God and without doing anything can be so passive and not active about the things of God. No, can just remain undecisive, can just remain indifferent. Elijah told the people, for how long will you waver between two opinions? If the Lord be God, serve him. And if it's Baal, then go after Baal. Praise the Lord. You know, rejection is a step after neglect. You know, people of God, we have enthroned another God upon our hearts. There cannot be vacuum. When you reject God, something else will take the place of God in your life. We have enthroned other things upon the throne of our hearts. We have sent God. We are making vain the essence of Easter. We have sent God out of his temple. I tell you, God is coming back into his temple. In the name of Jesus. The Bible talks of a king in the Bible, you know, that made a bronze suit to replace articles of gold that were taken from the temple. Nebuchadnezzar came into Jerusalem and took all the articles of gold out of the temple. And rather than seeking a replacement of articles of gold for gold, he began to make bronze articles to replace gold. People of God, this is the height of the sin that the church has committed. And it is the mother of other sins. Sins, rejection. Our nation has rejected God. We have rejected God. Here in this nation, a policy will be made that a preacher would need to get a license before he can preach. Rejection! And we have replaced God with the God of soccer, God of sports. You see how much now being rolled out on yearly basis on all of these things. You know, we have replaced God with the God of pleasure. Pleasure, pleasure, pleasure. Someone said, money is a natural bleaching cream. That when money comes, when you have money, your natural color will come out. You know, many of us, when we have pleasure, we forget about God. When David had pleasure, he forgot about God who gave him strength. He told his captain to go and number the people. Pleasure. When David, you know, was in pleasure, he could walk on the rooftop and he saw what he should not see. The little one that he prayed, don't give me too much so I may not sin against you. pleasure. We have replaced God with pleasure. And that is why you have amusement parks all over the place. You will be surprised that some areas they will say, no place for church. Yet there will be place for amusement park. Pleasure. We have replaced God with pleasures. You know, we have replaced God with materialism. Materialism, people of God. You see people of God, people would begin to carry fleets of cars simply because of what? You know, someone was telling me just now, you know, someone who is late and not vehicles that are parked in his compound that are not used. And the children do not have a need of it. Materialism. Materialism is another God that people are worshiping today. Even pastors, even leaders of God's people. You know, if a pastor has bought a particular car, other pastors in his clique will want to get that particular car. And they could do just anything to ensure they get that car. They rip off the sheep. They rip off the church of God. They empty the treasury of God in order to satisfy their quest for materialism. People of God, it is rejection. They see, you know, the God of intellectualism. Intellectualism. We begin to seek knowledge. 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 Intellectualism. These are some of the things with which we have replaced God, having rejected Him. People of God, hey, it is time to seek the Lord. God, there is a God that Jesus called, mentioned in the Bible. He called it Mammon. So you can always worship God. You can serve God together with Mammon. He's another God, people of God, that we have replaced God with. We don't care where anybody gets his money from, so long money rolls. And that is why you see prophets who would do Olosho night, who would do Yahoo night in the name of Jesus. And people will rush there simply because they want money. People of God, it is a time to seek the Lord. What have we enthroned as a nation? Democracy. Democracy. Democracy, the legislative arm of nations, are legislating against God, against the principles of God. They are legislating against the principles that brought them into power. The word of God says, a man must not marry a man. The nations are legislating man marriage to man. The word of God says, thou shalt not kill. The legislative arms of the nations are legislating abortion, legal killing. People of God, we have turned our back against God. What have we enthroned as a nation? What have we enthroned as an individual? What have we enthroned as a family against God? I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. So we need to identify the cause. Having identified the cause, what is the cure? What is the cure? And so I go to cure to national or global sickness. People of God, it is not the election of a new president. No. No. It is not the election of a new president that is the cure for our national issue. I tell you, people of God, what is happening to us is beyond the government nation of the earth. The strong government are failing. Technology has failed. No. It is not the election. It cannot be done by PVC. No. It has failed. That is not the cure. It cannot be done by the discovery of a vaccine. No, people of God. The vaccine can cure coronavirus, but no vaccine can cure sin. The only vaccine that cures sin is the blood of Jesus. And this cannot be done until we have turned back to Him. People of God, it is not the discovery of a vaccine. You see, the world power, the nations of the world are concentrating their energy on trying to discover the vaccine that will bring an end to this pandemic. But, oh, people of God, that is not the solution. That is not the cure. That is not the cure. We all need to return to God. You need to return to God. I need to return to God. Our nation needs to return to God. Our community needs to return to God. Our families need to return to God. We need to return to God. I do not mean our lackadaisical means of worship before now. No. God told the church at Ephesus, remember now where you are falling. Return to your first love. The church that God was talking to. It means that they were still holding service. They were still holding worship. They were still doing other things that church does. They were physically church, but spiritually they were far from it. We need to return to God. My brother, my sister, we need to return to God. And God has given us the opportunity. God would not be guilty of anyone after now, after what will happen after this season. Because you have the opportunity now to return to God and cry unto Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. You know, enough of playing the role of the five foolish virgins. Enough, they were virgins just like the five wise virgins. They have the same appearance of Christians. But the internal content were different. They attended the church the same way. But they do not see Jesus the same way. They were all preparing and waiting for the coming of the bridegroom, people of God. Enough of playing the role of the five foolish virgins. We need to get the extra that our life needs. We need to get the extra that our faith needs. We need to get the extra that we need to be able to meet up. To meet up when the bridegroom shall call. Don't tell me it is not possible. You know, a lot of it, people make a lot of joke with this. I was going through someone's status, I think today, and the person said, what if coronavirus is the right? What if those people that have died with coronavirus are the ones who have met the requirement? I began to look at how foolish. People of God, don't tell me it is not possible. God has just shown to us that beyond the sun, the stars, and the moon, there can be a global event by the global shutdown. And very soon, there will be another global event. This one is just a warm-up. This one is just a warming up. He that has ears, let him hear now. What is happening is just a rehearsal of the global event. Rapture will soon take place. Rapture should not make us afraid. Rather, it should make us joyful. We should expect it. We should expect it. You know, the last time there was this terrible sand that happened at Owo. You know, after Akure, our road after Akure. You know, some people said they thought that the rapture had taken place. For you to think that the rapture has taken place and you did not make it shows that something is wrong with you that you need to correct. We should have this conviction that if rapture had not taken place, because if rapture had taken place, I would not be here. We should be prepared. God is calling us to preparation. Careless, why will you linger, wandering from the fold of God? Hear ye now the invitation, oh, prepared to meet thy God. Careless, oh, hear the warning, for your life we soon be gone. Oh, how sad to face the judgment. Oh, prepared to meet thy God. prepare people of God, something which will happen. The thought of rapture should spark up joy in our hearts. We should expect it. We should pray like the apostles. Come now, O Lord. O Lord, come now to save us from all these evils. In the end of the scripture, if God's people call his name, God will only hear the cry and prayer of his people. Can you see that we have the vaccine? Hallelujah. It is the church that has the vaccine. We must use the vaccine. He said, my people, I have told you, it's a national disaster that has been addressed here. But he said, if my people that are called by my name, we humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their ways, I will hear. We, the church, have the vaccine. If you are not yet a part of God's people, you can enroll today. You can confess your sins. Ask Jesus to be your Lord and Savior. You can open up your heart unto him. You can cry unto him. You know, no matter what you do in church, if the thought of rapture still makes you afraid, you can sort yourself out now, people of God, and be a part of God's people. What are the requirements? Number one, humility. He said we must humble ourselves. We must get rid of the pride of our hearts. The pride has separated us from God. We must get rid of the pride. We must admit that we are not so smart as to eliminate God, and that we are not so strong as to depend on our own. We can be smarter than God. Many people will do it our own way, thinking we are smart. When procedures are given to us in church, when some things are told, we are asked to do some things in church, people of God. No. I can't bring pastor to this, no. We show that we are smart. We excuse God from our fears. People of God, if we can humble ourselves. If we can humble ourselves. The Bible says, God give grace to the humble. If we can get rid of pride of our heart, our own achievement, what we think we have achieved, we have attained by ourselves. People of God, that is needed. We must become humble. What is it now? Everything that the nations of the world trust in is failing them. You need to be humble. Everything they have, they need, is failing them. Even if you have money in the bank now, you can't access it. You can't. One of my sons at the orphanage had a medical issue, and yesterday I was at trauma center to attend to him. You know, 2 days ago, a doctor had told us the possibility of a surgery, and I was like, how do I get money for surgery? Even if you have the money in the account, the banks are on lockdown. They don't attend to checks. ATM cards, ATM machines are filled up. You know, whatever people have prided themselves in are failing now. So what is it? We need to humble ourselves. The second thing is, and pray. Prayer to God is an acknowledgement that we need his help. That we are not enough of our own. We need to pray. We need to pray, people of God. To pray and pray and pray and pray. We need to pray all the time you waste away on social media. Pray all the time you waste away doing some nonsensical thing. Hey, you have the opportunity now. Pray. Look for a corner. Raise an altar in your house. For your own corner, raise your own altar. There could be the family altar. There could be the individual altar. Don't allow this time to waste away. Pray to God. It is the only thing that connects us with God. Prayers. Seek his face. It's a step after prayer. That is, we seek his approval. We involve him in our lives. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. And lean not on your own understandings. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. That is how to seek his face. Seek his face. Get his approval. You know, people of God, don't depend on yourself. It is not only that we want him to help. We need him to know that, you know, we need to know what he wants us to do, and that we are ready to do what he wants us to do. And after we seek his face, we take a practical step of turning from our sins. Turning from our sin, the sin of forgetfulness, the sin of neglect, the sin of rejection. We turn away from those things. We turn away from them. And people of God, the result will amaze you. The result will amaze you. You want to ask me how I got to know? There was a city called Nineveh. God sent a prophet, Jonah, to that city. You know, the city was to die, was to be consumed, just like our own city is to be consumed by this plague. You know, people of God, these people, they hacking, they humbled themselves. The Bible says the king tore his garment. You know, he tore his garment. You need to tear your heart. You need to be sacrificed. You know, he descended. He turned away from his pride, from his throne, and he sat on the ground. He poured ashes upon himself. He declared a fast. He declared a national mourning. He declared a national convocation. And people of God, people cried, both human and animals. They fasted, they cried unto God. God hearkened unto them. Even when Jonah was not happy, God hearkened unto them. My God, we hear. He said, when you do this, he said, I will hear from my heaven. I will hear from heaven. Heaven is not so far, people of God. Heaven is close to us. If only we can use the channel of prayer. Heaven is close. Heaven is not far away. Heaven is close to us. He said, I will hear from my heaven. He said, you know, the hand of God is not too short to save, nor his ears too heavy to hear. But your sin has separated you. When we do this, people of God, he will hear. He said, I will hear. Not only will he hear, he said, I will forgive. And when the Lord forgives, he forgives totally. It is sweet to enjoy the forgiveness of God. I have enjoyed the forgiveness of God, and I know what it means to be forgiven of God. He forgives. And he says, not only will I forgive, I'm bringing healings. Every one of us, that is what we are looking up at. The healings. The Lord will bring healings. He will bring healings. Father, people of God, if we truly can do this, God will do what he has promised. He will bring healings upon our lives. He will bring healings upon our families. He will bring healings upon our community. He will bring healings upon our nation. And I'll tell you, people of God, healings upon the world. What should we do when there is a national emergency or when there is a national disaster? People of God, this is a sober moment in our lives. This is a sober moment in the history of our nation. It's a sober moment in the history of the world. But people of God, where have you erred? Haven't you forgotten about God? Haven't you neglected God? Haven't you rejected God? The answers are simple. Pray unto the Lord. Humble yourself. I wouldn't know if the Lord is pointing something to you. A throne that you have sat upon. Maybe that throne is at your education. The throne you have sat upon. Maybe that throne is that your talent. The throne you have sat upon. Maybe that throne is your beauty. The throne you have sat upon. Maybe that throne is your affluence. The throne you have sat upon. Maybe that throne is your connection. Maybe that throne is the money you have in your account. Maybe that throne is the job you have. Maybe that throne is anything. It could be anything. People of God, what is that throne that God is calling your attention to? Why don't you get down from that throne? Why don't you humble yourself? Why don't you tear your heart? Why don't you rend your heart? Why don't you call upon the Lord? He promised us, if we call, he will answer us. People of God, begin to speak to the Lord this time. Begin to speak to the Lord this time. Speak to the Lord this time. I need to repent. I need us to repent on behalf of our nation. Wherever you are listening to this broadcast, I need us to repent on behalf of our nation. Repent of the sin of forgetfulness. Lord, we are sorry. Lord, we represent Nigeria. We represent the world. We are righteous people here. Lord, in all the areas I have forgotten about you, Lord, have mercy upon me. I bring you back to your temple. Why don't you speak to the Lord this moment and represent Nigeria and say, Lord, Nigeria has forgotten about you. We have elevated other things above you, Lord. We repent on behalf of our nation. Nehemiah did that on behalf of Jerusalem, and God heard him. Why don't you say, Father, we repent from our sin of forgetfulness. We repent from our sin of neglect. We have neglected to worship you. We have neglected to call upon you. We have neglected to serve you. We serve other things. Lord, we are sorry. Lord, we repent of our sin of rejection. We rejected you. We have enthroned other things upon the throne of our heart. Lord, we humble ourselves. Lord, we humble ourselves. We repent of our evils. The evil of bloodshed in Nigeria. The evil of corruption in Nigeria. The evil of sin in Nigeria. We repent, Lord Jesus. Lord, have mercy on this nation. Let our cry for mercy arise from this place unto God. Let us cry for mercy over our nation. Do that. Let us pull down the high places of wickedness, the high places of corruption, the high places of killings in this nation, high places of sin, high places of Yahoo. Let us begin to pull it down. Ritual killings. Let us begin to pull down those high places over this nation. Let us cry to the Lord. Lord, we pull down high places of wickedness in this nation in the name of Jesus. We call the Spirit of God. Let me know, ask the Spirit of God to take over the Nigeria. Let the Spirit of God take over the Nigeria. Let us dedicate Nigeria to the Lord. Let us dedicate Nigeria. Let's represent. Let's stand in the gap for our nation. And let us cry to God, Lord, heal our land. Lord, heal our land. Lord, heal our land. Lord, heal our land individually and collectively. Heal our land, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' most wonderful name, we have prayed. Our Father, we thank you. We know you are here with us. We know your Spirit has gone over Nigeria. We know, Lord, that righteousness is taking roots from every family. Righteousness. Every family, every city, every church, every state. Righteousness is taking place now. In the name of Jesus. We establish righteousness. We establish righteousness in the name of Jesus. Righteousness exalted a nation. Sin is a reproach to a people. We curse sin. We remove sin. We curse our reproach in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask, oh God, that you will heal our land. Heal us individually. Heal us collectively. Spare your people all from this evil, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah. Blessed be your holy name. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Thank you for watching this broadcast. The Lord bless you, real God. People of God, this is time that calls for action. Action, people of God. Let us take practical steps. Whatever the Lord has called our attention to, let us ensure that we take practical steps to repent from those sins and we begin to live our lives for God. The Lord bless you. In the name of Jesus. Let's go back to the platform as we bring the service to a close. Amen.